in a minute. Alyssa, let me ask you, because one of the big sort of stalking horses in this meeting is the issue of human rights. And I don't know, you heard James Rosen's report a moment ago, but I don't think our viewers necessarily understand just how bad China is when it comes to this issue.
Well, it has a terrible history of human rights violations, but what's really important now is that it's actually gotten worse. It's gotten worse recently. And the specter that we see today of a Nobel laureate rolling out the red carpet for the man who has imprisoned the most recent Nobel laureate.
The winner
really,
of the Nobel Peace Prize
really
is now
striking.
In prison in China because of some political dissent.
So we can talk about, you know, the wisdom of the decision to roll out the red carpet and give President Hu this state visit. But now that it's happening, it's very important. I think the dynamic that Steve and Monica just talked about actually is similar in the human rights realm. This idea that it's sort of a zero-sum game and we have to pull back on human rights because, you know, we have we're kind of in debt to the Chinese on other issues. I think that's completely
wrong-headed. Casey McFarland said yesterday, "You don't pick a fight with your banker."
Yeah, I think that's completely wrong-headed. This is not a zero-sum game, and in fact, I think respect for human rights has to be at the center, not just of our diplomacy, but of the relationship. The U.S.-China relationship, all these other issues, whether it's the economy, global warming, security, we will not make serious progress on those issues unless the relationship is built on respect.
But does
for human
it work?
Rights.
I mean, so let's say President Obama, you know, does that with President Hu, and they talk about it, and we get lip service. Does the Chinese president do anything really when he goes back to China as a result of our pressure on human rights?
Well, I'll tell you, the value of it is this open and public.